The next on the list is the Eyedropper Tool. The eyedropper is used to sample the color from the artwork. To use the tool, click on the color you want to sample to set it as your foreground. Notice as I'm clicking how the color changes in the tool palette color box. Hold Option key and click on the color you want to set as your background. Note that you can sample the color from any open document without activating it. The Hand tool allows you to navigate around your document. Just click and drag to preview different areas of your artwork. And finally, Zoom tool. It's very helpful to zoom in and out of your document. To zoom in, either click on the document or click and drag around the area you want to zoom into. Hold Option key and click on the document if you want to zoom out. You will also use the toolbox to work with foreground and background colors, represented by two overlapping squares. The top square represents and allows you to set foreground color. The bottom square represents and allows you to set background color. To select a new color, click on the respective square for color picker window. By default, color picker is set to the hue options, with a hue bar in the middle and saturation and brightness values on the left. You can set the view based on saturation, brightness, red, green, and blue values. I prefer to use hues options. To pick the color, click inside the hue bar. You can adjust it by dragging the hue sliders up or down. Then click on the sample window on the left for the desired saturation or brightness. The new color swatch will show in the preview window where it says New, with the original color right below it, labeled as Current. You can click on it if you want to reset to the initial color. In addition to choosing color based on its appearance, you can enter specific numeric values. Most commonly used is RGB standard. RGB stands for red, green, and blue, with color range from 0 to 255, where 0 stands for no color and 255 maximum color. Understanding RGB spectrum is very important. Another option to select a color is to use libraries. Adobe Photoshop offers a large variety of them. Pantone standards are the most commonly used. Unfortunately, this feature is not that useful to fashion designers. First of all, the fashion industry is using Pantone Color Textile Standard, which is not available in Adobe programs. And second, the libraries are not printable. Regardless of how the selected colors look on the screen, they will look different in the print. You've probably noticed this discrepancy before. There are many factors affecting your colors in the final output, and it's imperative to understand them. You can go to the Designer's Nexus store and click on Printable RGB Color Palette Swatches. In the introduction and instructions, we explain in details what affects printed colors and how to go around it. The color library is for convenience only. You don't need to buy it to get the full information. Just read everything on the page. Let's go back to the picker window. Just click the picker button on the right. In addition to setting your foreground and background color, you can also add it to the swatch palette. To do so, click on Add to Swatches. Name your color and click OK. You could see a new swatch in the swatch palette on the right. If you are happy with the color, simply click OK, or cancel out if you want to go back to the original color. The new color will be displayed in the respective color box. In my case, it's foreground. Let's explore other color commands available in the toolbox. The first icon on the left below the zoom tool sets the foreground and background colors to default settings. Black for foreground and white for background. The double arrow on the right allows you to swap between foreground and background colors. To do so, just click on the icon.